As the old saying goes, there's more than one way to pet a cat, and there's more than one way to construct a graph in SPSS. One way is using the chart builder, and that is what we're going to learn about today as we learn about making graphs and figures using SPSS. We get to the SPSS chart builder by using the drop-down menu, Graphs, Chart Builder. Now, the first time that you use SPSS Chart Builder, you may see this warning box. Feel free to read it or ignore it, but whatever you do, click on the box that says, "Don't show this dialog again." Then click OK, and we can get started. So this is the SPSS Chart Builder. This is where all of the chart building will be done. So before we dive in, let me give you an overview of this dialog box and how we are going to use it. Now, this dialog box may look slightly different because I have already started working in it. Now, by the way, the data set that I have open here is Clickers.sav, and I will be introducing you to this data set in a moment. So first, let me familiarize you with the areas of the chart builder that you will want to know about. And let's start down here in the gallery. The gallery is where you choose the type of graph that you want to create. For instance, bar graphs, or scatter plots, histograms, or box plots. Once you have chosen your test, you will see the options available for that type of test in the chooser. Now, in this example, I've chosen a simple bar chart. There are 8 types of charts available in the bar gallery. You can use the mouse to hover your cursor over any of the icons to show its name. So to create a simple bar chart, I will drag the simple bar icon up into the canvas. This will cause the canvas to change appearance. The canvas is where a preview of sorts will display as I'm setting up a graph. This is not a true preview, and the graph that you see in the canvas will not look like your final graph. If you're seated next to someone in the computer lab, your canvas will not look like their canvas, even if you do exactly the same steps, with the same variable, at the same time. It's not a problem. Now here in the upper right, we have all of the variables in the variable box. Now right now, we're looking at variable names. If you want to see the variable labels, right-click on any of the variable names and choose Display Variable Labels. In the canvas, we have 2 drop zones for the X and Y axis. I can drag variables from the variables box to the X-axis drop zone or the Y-axis drop zone. Some drop zones will accommodate dropping more than one variable when doing repeated measures graphs. Finally, we can tweak the settings of the resulting graph in the element properties. For instance, we can add labels to the X or Y axis, or decide whether to report a mean or a percentage. So those are the basics of the chart builder. Now let me tell you more about the data set that we will be using. The data set that we will use for almost all of the graphing examples is called Clickers.sav. Now, these are data collected by my colleague, Dr. Kristen Tivner, that we published in a 2016 article for the journal Educational Technology and Society about the use of clickers in improving education and group discussions. The suffix .sav after clickers tells you that this is an SPSS dataset. And we will use a variety of the variables from this dataset. So here is the research design. Students were seated at tables during a seminar. 3 times during the seminar, students were asked to participate in a group discussion and then vote on an answer using their clicker. At some tables, everyone at the table had his or her own clicker. Now at other tables, the table shared a single clicker, so the group had to vote on a group response. One of our research questions was whether students who shared a single clicker with other group members participated in an active exercise more or less than the students who used individual clickers. Would having a shared clicker change the level of student participation? Level of participation was measured among 166 seminar participants after each of 3 rounds of group interactions. Later, students were asked whether they would prefer having an individual clicker. Participation and preference for an individual clicker were both measured using a Likert type rating scale with scores ranging from 1 to 7, where 7 equals high participation or high preference, and 1 equals low participation in the group or low preference for an individual clicker. We also asked about gender. We will use the Clickers.sav dataset extensively as we learn about graphing in SPSS. Go ahead and open the dataset now in SPSS before you continue through the rest of the videos.